Barely a month after Chief Sunday Igboho blasted Oni of Ife, Oba Adeyeye Ogunwusi, for visiting President Muhammadu Buhari at Aso Rockover Insecurity in Yoruba land, the monarch was seen together with the Sultan of Sokoto and others at the presidential villa on Thursday afternoon. The security situation in the country is one everyone has to... It is something that affects everyone. So regardless of your title and position, imagine, just take for instance, even if you are the Oba or you are the Sultan, whatever position you occupy, if insecurity has wiped away all the people, you are only in that position because there are people. If there are no people, then that's your position is of no effect. It doesn't have any significance. So I believe that... regardless of their position right now, it is something of importance. It's something really, really serious that all of these traditional rulers, monarchs, should get involved. If they are sitting quiet and folding their arms, then something is really wrong, because another reason they were elected is not just to remain as Oba or as to remain as Sultan of their various regions, but is also to lead, to guide, to support, protect the people, protect indigenes of their communities as well. We recall that when this Fulani herdsmen crisis started, the Sunday Igboho, we know him very well, the popular Yoruba activist who stood up for his community in Oyo State, gave the order that Fulani herdsmen should evacuate the Ibarapa North local government area of the state, gave them eviction notice. That came after Ondo State Governor Rotimi Akeredolu. Rotimi Akeredolu gave his own ultimatum as well. His was actually 7 days, and there was a leeway stating that if you don't want to evacuate, then come and register with the appropriate authority. We want to know where you live, where you reside. If there are any concerns, we know who to call on, where to go to. So in the midst of all of that, the crisis, Sunday Igboho actually attacked, lambasted the Oni of Ife. He really, really did. But we know how everything transpired later. He did offer some apologies to him for the kind of comments he made against him. But right now, what the news we're getting right now is that all of this monarch, they all gathered at the presidential villa. I think it's beginning to dawn on them that they need to act up. They don't just need to wait for the governors, the state governors. The governors alone cannot do this. If they are enjoying those positions, you know, whichever position they occupy, there's a lot of reverence, a lot of respect that goes with that position. So it's not only the respect and the reverence and all the things they enjoy, they also need to be responsible as well for the people. They know that when there are situations like this, they need to play their role. And you know, just recently, just yesterday, yeah, they all went to President Muhammadu Buhari. They went to the villa. We'll bring more details what is going on. But before we do, guys, please don't forget to like, share, and to subscribe. Thank you once again. Also, press on that notification bell, guys. Please press the bell until it turns gray. God bless you. The Sultan of Sokoto led the delegation of some selected monarchs in the country to President Muhammadu Buhari. The details of the meeting have not been revealed to the public. However, it is believed to be connected to the security challenges the country is facing. After Sunday Igboho forcefully evicted the Fulani people from the Ibarapa North local government area of Oyo State over atrocities of herdsmen in the community, the Oni of Ife visited President Muhammadu Buhari at Aso Rock. Igboho condemned the monarch for visiting Mr. President at that time. He accused the king of receiving dollars from the president to sabotage the interest of Yoruba people. Oni of Ife claimed that his visitation to the villa is for the interest of Yoruba people. Sunday Igboho later apologized to the monarch after he was roundly criticized by the Yoruba people. So these monarchs, we've just got a report that if you can see following from the photos, they were all with President Muhammadu Buhari, although their main reason they did not actually open up to journalists to actually get reports on why they were there. Maybe because it's something relating to the security of the country, they don't want to say it out in the open. We do not know, but very well we know that it's very connected with what is actually going on in the country right now. The crisis we are facing, the herdsmen crisis right now, is kind of looking like it's an ethnic crisis. But we are one country. Some persons are already agitating that if President Muhammadu Buhari is not ready to do the needful, is not ready to defend the cause of the whole country, then what are we waiting for? You know, even the agitation of Oduduwa people, the OPC, Oduduwa People's Congress is there. Biafra, they've got their own as well. And the times we are living right now, they are really, really challenging times. And it's not out of place. It's not out of place if these monarchs, they go to President Muhammadu Buhari, probably seeking what is Buhari really doing in their communities. You know, in the north, kidnappings here and there, even in the southwest, the Fulani herdsmen, even despite the evacuation notice that have been given to them, we'll be surprised to note that attacks are still being carried out of these Fulani herdsmen on farmers. They still attack farmers. The crisis is far from being over. Most probably these monarchs, they know that President Muhammadu Buhari knows the right thing to do. He knows what to do to totally end it. So they feel like if they avail their presence, if they meet President Muhammadu one-on-one, Buhari will be able to tell them what he's doing or what he intends to do. So let's hope that they've actually made some headway, because they did not really speak to journalists. They didn't let the purpose of their meeting in the open. They didn't speak everything out. And Nigerians are stating different things. Someone stated that after they have spoken to the president, will they take another direction? And you know, these even monarchs, some monarchs have been they've been classified as politicians as well. You know, when Igboho started with that, when he was criticizing the Oni of Ife, the direction he went was that the Oni of Ife is playing politics with all of this. He has actually collected some sort of dollars to go the same path of the president to ensure that the herdsmen are not sent out. But let's hope that their meeting, the reason for their going there, is at the interest of the people, not for their own personal interest. Because in the first place, they are being appointed to head, to lead, to support, to guide, to protect. Everything they do is for the people. Another one says that, can they solve our problems? What is happening is not a joke. Would President Muhammadu Buhari listen to their advice? They are men of integrity. Most of them are retired generals. Very correct. You know, a lot of persons have visited President Muhammadu Buhari, gave him different advice, even concerning the Sheikh Gumi. Nigerians have spoken that that man needs to be arrested. Buhari has not done any of that. So this person's concern is that it's a good thing that these monarchs, they've all went to see the president. But will the president actually listen to their advice? Will he do whatever he's being told to do? Another person has a different school of thought, says saboteurs, obas, and emirs, they've gone to collect money. You know, so some persons are feeling that the reason why they didn't let their meeting in the open, why they didn't allow the media to cover their meeting, is most probably because they want to compromise. You see, Nigerians don't trust all of these guys. You know, I told you that Nigerians look at some of these monarchs and traditional rulers as politicians right now, but that is not meant to be that way. You know, it's not all about politics. Regarding traditional rulers, they are not elected. Nobody votes for them. So they are not politicians. But with the way some of them behave these days, that is why Nigerians have started classing them as politicians. But anyway, my people, let's hear your own take down below in the comment section. Thank you once again for staying tuned. Please don't forget to like, share, and to subscribe. Till I come your way again with more updates. Bye for now, and God bless.